Here we're going to talk about how to start setting up your frequency distribution table. We're going to look at the variable monthly food expenses, and we have the descriptive statistics already produced. From that, some useful pieces of information for starting your table are the minimum and maximum, as you see highlighted here in the orange and green. So we have a minimum of around $250 and a maximum of approximately $450. So that informs your bin choice. We might want to start around $250, and since there's some spread of about 5 or 6 classes of width 50 between those two numbers, we might space these upper bounds or bin values by 50. Notice I've entered 250 and 300 into that column, highlighted those two numbers, and then I'm going to use the right bottom corner drag down option to get some additional numbers, repeating that sequence of incrementing by 50. Now, what do these numbers mean in the context of a frequency distribution table? Those are your upper bounds for each class. So that first one is indicating that monthly food expenses up to $250 per month will be counted as in that class. The next one picks up from there, so those that spend over $250 and up to $300 is indicated by a bin value of 300. So you can fill in the interpretation for the remaining classes there. Now let's look at how do we get the count for each of these classes. Our data is in column A. One way that we can do this is by using the count if function. And notice the criteria range is your first argument. That's the data itself, and we have that in column A. And we can indicate that if there's nothing else but that data in the column, you can just use the letter colon and repeat the letter. That will highlight the entire column. Then we have a comma, and our criteria follow. We only need one for this particular class. Up to 250 is going to be less than or equal to 250. Notice I've placed that in quotation marks. Close paren, enter. That's what we would expect because our minimum is $253.60. So we would not have any up to 250 or less than 250. Now for our next class, let's start that function again. The COUNTIFS function. If you're using Google Sheets, notice how you could recall what you just entered. So that can be useful for being efficient. However, for this one, we're going to have to edit the criteria. Notice we had less than or equal to 250 for that last one. Now we need greater than 250. And here's where the count ifs piece comes in because we have additional criteria for this class. How this works is we type or highlight our data again and make an additional criterion upon that data. Here we need it to be less than or equal to 300 as well as that first condition greater than 250. Enter, and you see there we have 10. You can repeat that process to fill in the frequency column using the count ifs function. Another way that you can determine the frequency is by highlighting this entire frequency column up to the last class that you want. Then starting the function frequency, so I've typed in the equal sign, started typing frequency, click it, and the way the frequency function works is you highlight your data first. I'm going to enter for column A. then a comma. Highlight your classes, so that's the bin values, not your descriptions of the classes, the upper bound, the bin value column. Then, since we want this to populate down that whole column, we have to press Control Shift Enter. If you were using Excel, it would just automatically calculate after you enter those keys. But notice in Google Sheets, it changes it to array formula, and that's okay. You just want to go with that and press Enter. However, since I have this reference, I need to take that out. So I'm going to press Delete on what we had in there before. And let's just construct that one more time. It's best to start with a clear column if you're using this option. So we'll set it up just like before. And Control Shift Enter, Enter. And there you see we have the entire frequency column populated by that set of actions. You'll get some extraneous information if you're using Google Sheet, possibly with Excel, so you can just delete that or ignore it. It's not allowing me to delete it since we have that array function there. You may just ignore that. Then let's talk about how we get our relative frequency column. We have a total number of observations here of 26. So we can figure our relative frequency by starting a function equals, clicking the frequency, then the division key, and notice here we could reference the count 26 and enter. So that is what we would expect. If we were to just drag that down, notice the references are not correct. It's referencing our maximum over here. So how do we correct for that so that it doesn't pull down into that descriptive statistics table? We go back into our original function and place dollar signs around the letter to hold it fixed in that cell. So once you update that, you can then go back to that original cell. Just going to take this out for clarity. Double click in there, see what's going on with that function. We're referencing frequency and total count of the sample, or N. And we want to drag this down. We want the orange box to come down with us and the purple box for count to stay fixed. That's why we have the dollar signs around it. And click back on the cell, use your right bottom corner drag down, and there we have our relative frequency. With these, you can play with the format by going to your ribbon at the top. Notice there's one for percent. So you might select that so that it converts them to percent. You also have a decimal precision indicators, so you can take that to the left or right to however many decimal places. We'll just leave that on two decimal places. And finally, for cumulative frequency, we want to take the amount in that row plus any amount from previous classes. So for the first class, it will simply be the relative frequency from that row. For subsequent classes, we need to program a formula by referencing what is in the row plus what is in the row directly above. And let's think about the drag down there. Do we need to fix either of those cells? No, because we want both of them to come down as we drag down that formula. So I'll press Enter there, then come back to the cell. My bottom right-hand corner drag down, pull it through the last row there, and let's look at that and just confirm. You can double-click in any cell to see it's operating appropriately as you want. And we can check some of the math there. Notice 38.4 and 34.6 do add to 73 and some change there. What is not working with that formula notice is that we're not getting a cumulative effect down that column. So how can we fix that? Well, let's go back to our formula and think through it a bit. If I instead reference the cumulative frequency from directly above instead of the latest relative frequency, then that would correct for the problem there. So I notice I have taken out the previous relative frequency, and now we're referencing the previous cumulative frequency. Let's see if that works. Take these out for clarity. We have an updated formula here. Press enter, then come back to your cell. Use your right-hand bottom corner, drag down of the formula, and there we have something appropriate for the cumulative frequency column. Notice they are accumulating. For example, if we consider all three of these classes, they add up to 84% in the last row that we're considering there. And then add in another 11%, you're up to 96 and some change. And notice by the end of your distribution, you will have accumulated or counted for all the cases in your data. All of the observations should be accounted for by the end of your frequency distribution table. And so that's a confirmation that we have set that formula appropriately, that we're getting a cumulative frequency of 100%. So that's an overview of how you can start setting up your frequency distribution table. Notice also, it's a good idea to label what it is that you are showing the frequency distribution of, and we have done that here for monthly food expenses, also indicating the sample size, 26. Thanks for tuning in for this overview, and best wishes creating your frequency distribution table.